September 11th, 1973, you know, is one of the many events in history where imperialist governments, imperialist powers, have interfered and intervened by brutal military means to overthrow democratically elected governments. And that was the case with Allende, who was democratically elected through the ballot box, which is, you know, quote unquote, democracy in the eyes of the West.
Venía de este concepto, de esta búsqueda a un país solidario. Venía de una experiencia de jóvenes de los años 60 que habían participado en un trabajo voluntario, que habían luchado por la democratización de las universidades, que aplaudían el hecho de que algunas universidades estuvieran abriéndose a los sindicatos de trabajadores. Esa era la óptica, nosotros estábamos metidos en esa cultura.
Cuando Allende se elige, indudablemente se produce una efervescencia al movimiento popular, se organiza más rápidamente todavía el movimiento de masa y comienza a generar lucha, por un lado de apoyo al gobierno popular y por otro lado de presión también al gobierno popular para que desarrolle las aspiraciones, digamos, que este pueblo tenía por tantos años, ¿no?, esperando que se termine la miseria, que se construya una sociedad más justa e igualitaria.
Que se les grave profundamente. No tengo otra alternativa. Solo acribillándome a balazos podrán impedirme voluntad que hacer cumplir el programa del pueblo.
Un poco pilló de sorpresa. Y fue así porque indudablemente lo aceleraron, a mi juicio, porque la gente, las organizaciones populares, los partidos de izquierda se estaban preparando también porque ya se habían dado cuenta de que venía. Pero desgraciadamente se dieron cuenta un poco tarde. Pinochet y compañía, junto a la CIA y al imperialismo, aceleraron el golpe y de ahí que lo hicieron el 11 de septiembre.
We were so young. I was 3 when we left Chile. So you think, you know, the family made it. Obviously we were exiled, we had to leave. That's not an easy situation. But compared to what happened to a lot of families, compared to what still happens to a lot of families all around the world, it really wasn't as violent or as horrible a situation. That's what you think, right?
My father was a communist, a member of the Communist Party, and he was a political prisoner, and he spent some time in you know, the soccer stadium in Concepcion and then another place down south. So we had to leave, right, when he was out of prison. So in one sense, we were still lucky, right, because, you know, I have friends, I knew friends who also, they lost their parents, right, or some of them never even met their parents. And so I think in one sense, we're lucky that we were able to leave.
Un día me llaman por los parlantes y me dicen, firma aquí. Firmé, pues. Y era de que venía saliendo para afuera, me llaman para mi casa. Y afuera estaba mi señora con mi hija, Sandra. Y mi hija, cuando me vio salir de ahí, partió corriendo, me abraza y se puso a llorar. Yo le dije, hija, no derrame una sola lágrima delante de estos conches de su madre. Estos guanes son unos traidores, así que no merecen lágrimas de nosotros. Y los pacos ahí. Hijo, iba saliendo de estar. Pero venía con esa rabia.
Para mí fue una demarcación bien concreta en la terminación, en el final de lo que era una niñez completamente normal. Después el mundo ya era todo loco, era siempre con el miedo de esto, con el miedo de esto otro, y no saber dónde estaba mi papá, y estar en una situación más que nada que uno no entendía en ese momento, pero sabía de que no había dinero para la comida, que no había dinero para nada. Entonces era un cambio total de lo que había sido nuestra vida antes de que pasara el golpe militar.
Llegué al aeropuerto de Vancouver sin ningún cinco, sin ningún dólar en los bolsillos. Había una persona ahí recibiendo seguramente a todos los refugiados que venían de Argentina. Y se acercó una señora y me dice, aquí tiene $70, señor. $70 en ese tiempo era plata. Yo podía haber llenado el refrigerador con $50. Entonces lo sirvió un montón.
¿Y la señora quién era?
La señora no la conocí. Nunca supe quién era. Ni tengo idea quién fue, pero uno un poco asustado de no entender el idioma y de ver que el destino no era Vancouver, sino que Edmonton. Entonces teníamos que buscar luego cómo embarcarlo en otro avión para llegar a Edmonton.
Los ríos son como venas de un cuerpo entero extendido, y es el color de la tierra, la sangre de los caídos. No somos los extranjeros, los extranjeros son otros, son ellos los mercaderes y los esclavos nosotros. Yo quiero romper la vida como cambiarla quisiera. Ayúdeme, compañero, ayúdeme. No demore, que una gota con ser poco, con otra se hace aguacero.
A lot of the children of the exiles lived a very confusing and difficult life because parents were going through a difficult time adjusting to Canada, assimilating to Canadian culture, and for us it was very difficult trying to understand what our parents were going through at such a young age.
You grow up in Canada, you know, very safe place, very, very easy to do what you want to do in life. But deep down inside, I think there's always been, deep down, like subconsciously, there's always been the injury, the subtle something happened when we were kids, when we were babies.
Después de 22 años de vivir en Canadá, siento una alegría inmensa por lo que está sucediendo. Por fin se está haciendo un poco de justicia por todos los crímenes cometidos en mi país, Chile. Yo fui echada de mi país con 6 hijos. Mis 6 hijos fueron expulsados de mi país por ser hijos de un traidor, según ellos, de un simple obrero, quien fue detenido y estuvo en campo de concentraciones. Yo también fui golpeada por los militares y fui realmente humillada. Y llegué sola a este país con 6 hijos. Le doy gracias al pueblo canadiense, al gobierno canadiense que en ese momento me recibió. Pero para nosotros es terrible. Pienso de que ahora se está haciendo un poco justicia y me siento contenta de que él sienta un poquito que está en un país extranjero detenido de lo que él nos hizo a nosotros. Y es bueno que ya se haga justicia. Agradezco a los españoles que han tenido, como se dice, cojones para luchar y detener detenido a un fascista como él, que no tiene perdón. No puede haber olvido cuando hay 3.000 desaparecidos, cuando existieron cientos de detenidos en Chile, campos de concentraciones. No hubo respeto ni por los religiosos, ni por los jóvenes, ni por los ancianos. Muertes en las calles, eso no se puede olvidar.
¡Viva Chile! ¡Viva!
McLean no es un accidente que hizo esa declaración para decir de que lo que había hecho Pinochet en Chile no estaba mal después de todo. Veía que no iba a tener reacción, pero sin embargo tuvo reacción y en ese sentido debemos felicitar a los grupos progresistas canadienses con el partido del NDP, la Nueva Democracia a la cabeza, y donde los chilenos reaccionamos, digamos, frente a eso, ¿no? Fue gente al Parlamento, digamos, a plantear lo que valió, digamos, de que el Klein tuvo que disculparse, pero esa es una disculpa de los dientes para afuera nomás, porque indudablemente lo que dijo lo siente, como lo siente el resto de la derecha.
About 26 years ago, I gave my very first political speech, and it was at a rally at the Provincial Museum marking the 5th anniversary of the coup. And I was a student leader at that time, bringing words of solidarity with the student leaders in Chile who were being murdered by the junta. Well, the rest of the world stood by. And since that time, the Chilean people have fought their way back to democracy. And there have been tremendous struggles along the way. Let's not forget the thousands of people who disappeared, the people who were murdered, that the democratically elected president of Chile was assassinated. And it was a coup that was engineered by the United States in connection with the Chilean military in order to protect the position of American corporations in Chile. Now our premier, in response to demands for public auto insurance, invokes the name of Salvador Allende and Augusto Pinochet. And he said in the legislature that Pinochet was justified. He had to make the coup because Allende was a communist. So in that context, we have to ask, is the premier saying that if a democratically elected government of Alberta brings in public auto insurance or some other measure with which he disagrees, that it's justified to remove them from power through military means and shoot them? Is that what he's saying? Well, I thought...
That's what he's saying.
Well, then the premier is not a Democrat, is he? What is he?
Fascist.
He's a fascist.
It is time that Mr. Klein be held accountable for his irresponsible, arrogant, disrespectful, and insensitive attitude. Yeah. We as Chilean Canadians will not let him get away with victimizing us once more. Our wounds are still open, and we want some closure to the horrendous episodes of abuse and systematic persecution. We're thankful to Canada for receiving us, but we will remain vigilant so that nothing like the events we went through in Chile happen again.
Many of you have come to Canada and been embraced by Canadians and Albertans. On behalf of all the citizens of Edmonton, I would ask that Premier Klein apologize and apologize now.
Clearly, it's the Chilean community still has to struggle for an understanding of what happened in Chile, for respect. People came to Canada in hopes of finding human dignity and respect for their history and their struggles. And clearly, when the leader of a government can take this kind of position, it shows that there's a lot further to go in that struggle.
Existe una ley en Chile, la hizo el gobierno de Ricardo Lago ahora, para ver a todos los que estuvimos presos. Fuimos torturados y exiliados a la vez. Porque de muchas personas que hay aquí, hay muchas que el régimen dictatorial de Pinochet lo echó fuera de Chile, con la ley 504. Entonces, en todas partes del mundo hay chilenos que se acogen a esta ley, que es una ley de listado de prisioneros, políticos y torturados, como lo dice el título aquí.
Ahora acá nosotros estamos todos reunidos acá con el cónsul y esperando, digamos, firmar los papeles. Acá ven aquí alrededor que estamos, llegó bastante gente acá de los chilenos que realmente estuvieron comprometidos con la causa en Chile y que bueno, algo que pueda llegar, como digo, y podamos recibir una pequeña compensación.
lo más importante que yo encuentro de todo no es la plata, lo importante habría sido que se les juzgara y se les llevara a la corte a todos los asesinos, a todos los torturados y asesinos de Chile.
Este es mi pasaporte de la República de Chile. Cuando salí en agosto del 80. Salí. Se está cayendo a pedazos. Hacen 25 años que no lo uso. Te voy a mostrar la visa. La visa que me entregaron hace 25 años, que tengo que abrirla con cuidadito para que no se destruya. Ahí está mi visa de ingreso a Canadá como London, permanent London immigrant. Compara ese tiempo y ahora, 30 años después.
Si no creyera en la locura de la garganta del sinsonte, si no creyera que en el monte se esconde el trino y la pavora, si no creyera en la balanza, en la razón del equilibrio, si no creyera en el delirio, si no creyera en la esperanza, si no creyera en lo que agencio, si no creyera en mi camino, si no creyera en mi sonido, si no creyera en mi silencio. Fuera la masa sin cartera, una masita chamo de caderas y tendones, un revoltijo de carne con madera, un instrumento sin mejores resplandores, que necesitas montadas para escena. Qué cosa fuera, corazón, qué cosa fuera.
My youngest one, who was born here, was very passionate about the news today because she was the one who actually turned the TV on today, and she found out and she said, "Mom, Pinochet has died," and we knew that he was sick, and I said, "Oh no, it's not possible." So I went into a shock and I started crying, and she said, "Mom, you should be happy," and I said, "Actually, I'm not," and she said, "But how come you cannot be happy? Today is supposed to be the happiest day of your life." I said, "Because this guy has left this world without any punishment. And when I think about probably the only taste of punishment that he had is when he stayed in London under house arrest. That was the only taste of punishment. The rest, nothing happened. All our families were broken. So I don't think it's fair that he just died in peace in the hospital. You know, that's what I said, today is a bittersweet day for us.
Remember when we stopped the street
when with our caravan of car, sometimes walking, was a good fight. Mm-hmm. We should feel very proud of that.
You have to respect and appreciate people who fought for justice at home and then faced a devastating coup, come to another country altogether and pick up where they left off, fighting for social justice, fighting for peace, fighting for the rights of workers and for women. This is an amazing thing, and the contributions that those people have made have helped change our society and our city and our province for the better, and have contributed to the fact that we now have representation within the legislature that can speak out and work on behalf of those people.
I want the youth to understand that these people gave their lives. Giving your life to the development or to an ideology that benefits all of humanity is not something that you do one day or 2 days or for a year. Right? It's something that you do for your whole life. It's a way you live. Because if we want socialism to be real, if we want a progressive world, if we want a better world to come about, then we need to live it in our own lives first. And I would like to thank all those people who gave their lives to the struggle.
Bounce to this. The American dream looks like a nightmare to me, a nightmare to many people, billions actually, because each brick has been laid with slavery and only benefits a certain plutocracy. Imperial hegemony in the Western Hemisphere, so far from God, yet the devil so near. Why must so many feel the wrath of the Joint Chiefs of Staff, treating self-determined governments like naughty children? And the Global South has never been the beneficiary, cause the pimps that make the policies, they got stakes in the companies that profit from the pain of the people. And these episodes got many sequels, from Knox in Nicaragua to the Dulles in Guatemala, Bush and Cheney in Afghanistan and Iraq. People take the power back, yo.
Es evidente que todo lo que pasa en Latinoamérica está entrelazado no solo dentro de la historia de los países, sino que dentro de las historias de los países poderosos que han querido y han estado dominando nuestras naciones. En el caso de Latinoamérica, digamos Estados Unidos como fuerza imperialista, ha tenido mucho que ver con todas las transiciones, digamos, que hemos tenido en nuestros países, con todas las guerras, con todos los mismos tratados de paz, con los sistemas de injusticia, con los sistemas de explotación, con el derrocamiento de presidentes, no solo en Chile, o en Guatemala, en Nicaragua, en El Salvador, sino que en toda la América Latina, en Argentina, en Perú, en Bolivia, en la República Dominicana, en la misma Cuba y en Granada. O sea, todos esos acontecimientos políticos no pueden verse de manera aislada porque no son aislados. Son un problema que tiene un enemigo común, una raíz común, ¿verdad? Que todos sabemos que es los países poderosos, en este caso el imperialismo norteamericano.
Esa es la vida, digamos, del imperialismo norteamericano. Manchado, digamos, su mano de sangre del pueblo.
That happened in Chile, it happened in Argentina, it happened in Uruguay. You know, it's happening in Guantanamo, for example. It happened in these blackout prisons or black cells or whatever they're called, you know, in Eastern Europe and parts of the Middle East. And I mean, I think that, you know, history repeats itself and no one's paying attention to history.
Because it don't matter what part of the left you're on, we work together to bring down the hegemon. In solidarity, we champ down Babylon. Cause we be the people's poets. And we be the people's poets. Cause we be the people's poets.
I grew up in a culture where wealth was abundant and where you had a really good mind frame where you could do anything in the world. But what you wanted to do was self-gratification. It was like, yeah, but like, I want to have fun. I want things now. And so then growing up, I always knew I could do whatever I wanted to do, but I never heard that voice of truth. I felt like really lied to. And so when I found out about like, I connected the fact that I'm a refugee with what's going on right now in my education. All of a sudden, it's like my eyes opened and I saw the suffering of the world. And I'm like, yo, man, I'm going to speak on that and I'm going to tell people in the most powerful way possible.
Ahí está, digamos, la evidencia posterior. Hace poco año atrás fueron desclasificados los documentos de la CIA y ahí de nuevo reconocen algo que todos sabíamos en Chile, de que el imperialismo, la CIA, puso, y el Pentágono, puso plata, puso militares, puso gente, digamos, a trabajar en Chile para poder derrocar Allende.
For those of us who grew up in Canada, a very peaceful country, prosperous for most of us, questions of human rights are not ones that we think about a lot, but for the Chilean community, those were issues that were very prominent. Many of them had experienced abuses themselves firsthand or knew family members who disappeared or were imprisoned or tortured or worse. So they were people who, I think, helped raise the Canadian consciousness about the importance of issues like human rights and social justice. And I think Canada owes the Chilean community a debt of gratitude for their contribution in that sense.
Nuestros países ha dado abierto camino a luchas populares con grandes sacrificios, con a veces con pérdida de vidas, con resistencia frente a la tortura, con toda la situación que significa los desaparecidos. Pero cuando en mi generación se hace un balance de todo eso, se siente que la pena ha sido grande, pero todo valió la pena.
How the hell can we rest? Cause it's not free press when it's owned by the billionaires. The market's not free when it's run by the oligarchy. Where's the truth in this reality? When the rich hide their crimes against humanity. And there's no need for revealing this global glass ceiling that started with the fiend when they came from overseas, not bringing any peace, just guns and disease. Cause these nations were built on capitalist tendencies, on the backs, many backs of slavery. And on Thanksgiving, yeah, you won't be finding me serving pumpkin pie or eating turkey. I'm not celebrating centuries of colonial occupation and continued domination. What about the First Nations across the continent? Cause the governments be treating them like they don't exist. Cause we're all American, we should act like neighbors. We share our bread and we share the water. We share the land cause everyone on this earth deserves dignity from the time of birth. Your lifestyle here created refugees, so we won't ask please and we ain't begging. We here to teach you a lesson. Justicia para el pueblo. That's why we rebel, y'all. We stand tall, we bring on the brawl. For real, that's the deal. Cause I'm the third world breaking down your door. Not here for charity, but to throw you to the floor and say hell nah. My people are dying. We trying to be peaceful, but your people are lying. You don't wanna make this world a better place, cause you're too caught up in your mother tucker rat race. Keep your warm-hearted knife in the back embrace. History belongs to the people, y'all. And the truth is we'll defeat all. Comrades, stand tall to the call. This is for the poor and hungry behind the economic apartheid wall.
Another world is possible. 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 Another world is possible.
Let's do this, solidario.
Time to tear down the fence and shed this first world decadence that was laid brick by brick at other cultures' expense. History's made by the people and it says to me, take pride in our culture, live the memory. We remember how they live, we remember why they fought. Spread the hope that they brought, learn the lessons that they taught. We remember what they sang, cause music from the South is revolutionary. Music from the South be liberated. Music from these up be demonstrated. That's why we listen to Violeta Parra, Fela Kuti, Bob Marley, Victor Jara. Cause they coming from the South and their voices ringing out, they're all telling us that another world is possible. 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 Right. Put your hands up if you believe.
Put your hands up if you believe.
Another world is possible.
Otro mundo.
Otro mundo.
We want to thank you all so much.
When we come together, when we work in concert with one another to think about how we can make a better world, that's what it's all about.